उपास्महे यग्रीव यग्रीवेति यो वदेत् तस्य निःसरते वाणी जह्नुकन्या प्रवाहवतु। सो नमस्कारम्स टू दि लोटस फीट ऑफ द ग्रैंड मास्टर्स डॉक्टर हैनुमन, डॉक्टर टेंट, मास्टर वीके, डॉक्टर चरुपति and other doctors who are working for the spread of the system of homeopathy. And we are blessed to conduct these classes in a way to teach the people so that they will have some interest in knowing this divine science. I call this science as divine science because there is divinity in homeopathy.
This conference will now be recorded.
The divinity is the form of the medicine and the form of the God are the same. We all believe that there is God, but what is the shape of the God? Or what is the quantity we can predict of the God? Not known. But we feel him. We know that he is there. In a similar fashion, in homeopathy, there is medicine. We know that medicine is there because it works. It is giving relief to the sick. It is not a magic or a mayam mantra, nothing. The reason is, if the right medicine is selected for the right set of symptoms and the potency also is selected properly, automatically the medicine works. That is the proof. The proof is the result of the cure. If not selected, right medicine is not selected, if the medicine is not similar to the complaints of the patient, it may not work. So that is the proof. We want any evidence is required, evidence is our patient only. Patient comes and says, sir, I am okay, I am all right, I feel better. That itself is a proof for us. Scientifically, how the medicine works also will be proved in very near future. Already, a lot of research is going on. That day is not far where we prove the medicine, how it works. And I am sure already the work is going on in very, very near future. The system, how it works, will be known to us. And the scientists who manifest this principle, they deserve a Nobel Prize because it is going to bring a total change in the medical systems of the world, not only our country. It is going to pave path for a new medical thinking. Master E.K. was telling the pathology in the 20th century or 19th century, 20th only, it is at the primitive stage. It's like a postmortem. After the changes are observed in tissues, they will declare that you have this problem. You have sugar in the urine, sugar in the blood. That is nothing but after the disease sets in, diagnosis. The present diagnosis is that Master E.K. said that in 21st century, real pathology will be taught to the students. Let us wait and pray for that day where the pathology also will be known to us. As far as homeopathy is concerned, this is based on picture principles I told you. Today I am going to give some important points to note down for you so that if you listen, you will forget. If you note down, and again, if you go through the notes, there is every possibility that it will stay in your mind forever. So I will tell slowly the notes. Please note down. And then Google Mother is there. If any spellings are required, if you please go through the meanings and spellings in the Google, you will get all the information and you will understand the science. This notes what you are going to write should be preserved, and you have to read it again and again. I'm going to give you bullet points only. Notes means not full notes. The first point, please note down. The physicians, H-I-G-H-I, and only mission. The physicians, high and only mission, is to restore, R-E-S-T-O-R-E, restore the sick to health. Restore the sick to health. Comma, to cure, C-U-R-E. As it is termed, A-S-I-T-I-S, as it is termed, T-E-R-M-E-D. I repeat, the physician's high and only mission is to restore the sick to health, that is cure. So what is cure? Restoration of the health. That means health is lost and it is to be restored again. Arogyamu padaipoyindi, tirigi arogyanni pondatame homeopathy. I will be speaking Telugu also. There is some demand from the participants. Poyina arogyamnu tirigi ponduta. Ante original ga manandaram arogyavantulu. By birth, by nature, we are all healthy people. I will tell both English and Telugu. Originally, we are at ease. E-A-S-E, ease. Aram. Bavunnara ante bavun. That's called ease. ఆ ఈజ్ని మనం ఏం చేసుకోవాలి అంటే డిస్టర్బ్ చేసుకున్నాం. వీ హావ్ డిస్టర్బ్డ్ దట్ ఈజ్. సో వెన్ ద డిస్టర్బ్డ్ ఈజ్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ డిసీజ్. ఒరిజినల్లీ దెర్ ఈజ్ ఆర్డర్నెస్. దట్ ఆర్డర్ ఆల్సో వి డిస్టర్బ్డ్. అండ్ డిస్టర్బ్డ్ ఆర్డర్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ డిజార్డర్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ ద డ్యూటీ ఆఫ్ ది ఫిజిషియన్? ఇట్స్ నథింగ్ బట్ హెల్త్ వాజ్ దేర్ ఎర్లియర్. నౌ సమ్ డిసీజ్ ఆర్ డిజార్డర్ హ్యాస్ క్రప్ట్ ఇన్ ద పర్సన్. And we have to just restore it. It is lost and restore. Arogyavantulame modatlo madhyalo anarogyam vachindi. Anarogyanni pogottadam kaadu. Poyinatuvanti arogyanni tirigi techukovadam. Adokkate vaidyuni yokka mukhyamaina kartavyam. That is the only thing the doctor or the physician has to do. And fortunately, homeopathy is the science that depicts this theory only. The physician is always bothered in homeopathy for restoration of health only. Because we are not going to see the symptoms of the external person or how the sickness has come externally. We bother only about the person inside the person. Lopala unnatundi vyakti gurinchi manam ekkuva aalochistam. Atanki anarogyam ela vachindi ledha arogyam ela poyindi. తిరిగి ఆరోగ్యాన్ని పొందడం మాత్రమే ఫిజిషియన్ యొక్క కర్తవ్యం. ద ఫిజిషియన్, ప్లీజ్ నోట్ డౌన్, ద ఫిజిషియన్ షుడ్ క్లియర్లీ పర్సీవ్. ద ఫిజిషియన్ షుడ్ క్లియర్లీ పర్సీవ్, P-E-R-C-A-V-E, వాట్ ఈస్ టు బి క్యూర్డ్. వాట్ ఈస్ టు బి క్యూర్డ్ ఇన్ ఈచ్ ఇండివిజువల్ కేస్. What is to be cured in each individual case? Because he has learned to identify, I-D-E-N-T-I-F-I, to identify the symptoms, S-Y-M-P-T-O-N-S, symptoms, and to perceive what curative medicine is indicated. So what is the duty of the physician? Duty of the physician is to find out what is curable in disease. Clearly you should perceive each individual case, identify the symptoms. And as the theory I told you, similia similibus curantur. So like cures like. The physician has to find out a medicine which has the similar set of symptoms అండ్ అడ్మినిస్టర్ ఇట్ ఇన్ రైట్ పర్సన్స్. ఏ లక్షణాలైతే రోగి ఎందు ఉన్నాయో ఆ లక్షణాలే కలిగినటువంటి హోమియోపతి మందుని మనం కనుక్కొని అది కనుక రోగికి వెళ్ళగలిగితే అతను తిరిగి ఆరోగ్యవంతుడగును, స్వస్థతను తిరిగి చేకూర్చుట, అస్వస్థతలో ఉన్న ఆను పోగొట్టుట. దిస్ ఈస్ ది ఐడియా. అండ్ టు నో దట్ యూ షుడ్ నో ద పేషెంట్ వెరీ వెల్ అండ్ ద మెడిసిన్ ఆల్సో వెరీ వెల్. వై ఆస్ ఐ రిపీట్ సో మెనీ టైమ్స్ సంబడి ఆస్క్డ్ మీ, సార్ యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు టూ మచ్ ఫండమెంటల్స్, వి ఆల్ నో హోమియోపతి. Why I have chosen to start with fundamentals for beginners, there are some, of course, first time joining pressures are there. And for those who know homeopathy already, who are practicing also, there are some people who are attending, who are seniors. Why I am going for deep into the fundamentals? Because the fundamentals should be strong in us. Why are we not able to select a single medicine? Why are we not able to perceive the case properly? Because we have missed some links in the philosophy of homeopathy. That is why in homeopathy, philosophy is the most important aspect. Materia medica you can learn by observing, by working in a dispensary, or by going through various materia medicas, you can understand. But philosophy should establish in you in such a deep layers, very strong foundation. That is why I am repeating. I am sorry, those who are getting bored, you may have to bear with me. These 2 days I spent for juniors. So, when you give a medicine suitable to the symptoms of the patient, which are available in the materia medica, so medicine is available in materia medica, patient has come with certain symptoms. So you have to find out the right medicine and select a right potency. What potency is to be selected, you can learn by attending to the dispensary. ఎక్కడన్న వైద్యాలయంలో ఒక సీనియర్ వైద్యుడి దగ్గర పనిచేస్తే మీకు పొటెన్సీ ఎలా సెలెక్ట్ చేయాలి, ఎంత పొటెన్సీ చేయాలి, ఎప్పుడు రిపీట్ చేయాలి అనేది చెప్తారు. మేము కూడా కొంత మీకు పరిచయం చేస్తాం. సో వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఈజ్ పేషెంట్. పేషెంట్ ఈజ్ ద గైడ్ ఫర్ అస్. Diagnostic laboratory reports are secondary, not primary. You need to know whether the physiological functions are correctly working in person or not. All the organs are working properly or not. Remember, anatomy, physiology, pathology are all important. Should never ignore. It's a medical science. You are expected to know all the basics of everything. It's not that because I don't want to know anatomy, physiology, pathology. Should not say. All are important. There are sciences. They say about the human. So you learn everything. The next point. I told you I will give only bullet points. The physician should be. Preserver of health. P-R-E-S-E-R-V-E-R. The physician should be preserver of health by knowing. K-N-O-W-I-N-G. Those things, the physician should be preserver of health by knowing those things that derange health, and cause disease, and how to prevent them. It is not that we cure after the disease symptoms set in the person. We can also prevent that. We can also educate the patient how to prevent the onset of the disease. Like pandemic, you say, for example, corona, homeopathy, we have given to hundreds of people for prevention of corona. And it is the most successful experiment for us, we can say. Because many people, I give to hundreds of people. Even for those who are COVID positive also, they are treated with homeopathy and Ayurveda. Wonderful. That is why in our country, the deaths are very low. Those who have taken homeopathy and herbal, they are safe, in fact. I don't know exact statistics, but the number of deaths are very low. So the preserver of health, the physician only, ఆరోగ్యమును కాపాడువాడు, స్వస్థతను కాపాడువాడు వైద్యుడు. స్వస్థత ఎలా పోతుంది లేదా అస్వస్థత దేని వల్ల వస్తోంది అని తెలుసుకొని ఆ అస్వస్థతను కనుక మనం నివారణ చేయగలిగితే, ఆను తీసేయగలిగితే స్వస్థతే మనకి ఒరిజినల్. కాబట్టి స్వస్థతని మనం పొందవచ్చు. ఇది హోమియోపతిలో ఉన్నటువంటి సూత్రం. చాలా విచిత్రమైనటువంటి విశేషమైనటువంటి విషయం ఏంటంటే, ఈ స్వస్థత అనేది మనం కరెక్ట్గా కనుక చూడగలిగితే ఆటోమేటిక్గా మనకి తెలుస్తుంది. అంటే వీ విల్ కమ్ టు నో వట్ ఆర్ ద థింగ్స్ దట్ ఆర్ ద కాజెస్ ఆఫ్ డిరేంజ్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ ది హెల్త్ అండ్ హౌ టు ప్రివెంట్ దెమ్. సపోజ్ దే ఆల్రెడీ కమ్ ఇన్, దెన్ హౌ టు రిమూవ్ దెమ్ ఆర్ హౌ టు క్యూర్ దెమ్. దట్ ఈస్ ద పర్పస్. నెక్స్ట్, these experiments have been continuing. These experiments have been continuing for more than two centuries. Two and a half centuries, and have been checked. Have been checked and rechecked many times. We are not going to do experiments on any person, remember. Already the drugs are proved on healthy human beings. Not one person, 20 or 30 persons are given the medicine in crude form and they have written the symptoms that have come because of that medicine. And that medicine, after potentizing the same, they gave it to the sick people, and all the sick people, for those who are given a similar medicine, they have shown wonderful positive result. So we are not going to conduct any experiment. Don't think that in homeopathy you are doing experiments. No, you can do experiments for new medicines where you find a herb in our country and that is potentized, that is given to some healthy person in the beginning in the crude form, and then take the symptoms and then you give it to other persons who are sick. Those symptoms you can say that that is the experiment you are going to do on the human beings, that is sick. But all these medicines which are already proved, we are not doing any experiments for that. They are already done. Next slide. One more point. In this system, diseases are made known, K-N-O-W-N, by their symptoms. Diseases are made known by their symptoms and signs, S-I-G-N-S, signs and gurtulu, and their signs in the patient. This is the wonderful arrangement by nature. Whenever a disease causing substance enters the person, either at physical level or at mental level, psychological level, immediately the vital force tries to drive the disease out. And in that process, certain symptoms are created. Those symptoms, they are made as groups or sets, and they are named as diseases by allopathic system. Whereas in homeopathy, we have only sick people. That means once a disease enters the body, the nature sees that the disease is sent out, and in that process, some symptoms are manifested. What are those symptoms? Symptoms are only a sign, S-I-G-N, sign, are symptoms of the disease in the body. This means I told you the discomfort, desire. Ease is a disease. So they are made known to the physician. So physician has to observe and take down the cases properly. Once you take the case properly, then it is very easy for us to cure any person. Any person. I'm not using word any disease, or I'm not using any organ. No, it is the person that is the problem. This basic principle we should never forget while practicing homeopathy. You have to take the person into consideration. The person speaks of his symptoms. That is, he is speaking of symptoms means through the symptoms he is telling about his disorder. So this is the fundamental principle of a homeopathy. Only I am giving you only important bullet points I told you. The reason is, unless you know these things clearly, the foundation, then we go for medicines. I will tell you in Materia Medica also, you will be able to understand very easily, and giving the medicine also very easy once you know this philosophy. Many people, they will read the books and they try to give, they are failures. By reading Materia Medica, or by reading a bedside prescriber, or by going through only pathological symptoms, only physical symptoms, if we select a medicine, we are failed. So you know the philosophy, go deep into the person, find out the person, what the internal man is telling. That Hanuman calls him as internal man. In Telugu, we call it, Sanskrit, we call it as Antaryami, the indweller. వాళ్ళ లోపల నుంచి మాట్లాడుతుంటాడు, నాకు ఇదవుతోంది సార్, నాకు అదవుతోంది సార్, నాకు ఏమిటో అయిపోతుంది సార్ అంటాడు. ఏమిటైపోతుంది, ఏదో అయిపోతుంది అంటాడు. ఎకోనైట్ అనే ఒక డ్రగ్లో ఆ పేషెంట్ చెప్తాడు ఖచ్చితంగా, సార్ నేను రేపు సాయంత్రం, రేపు ఉదయం లేకపోతే ఇవాళ సాయంత్రం రాత్రి 10:30 నేను చచ్చిపోతున్నాను సార్ అంటాడు. ఈ ప్రెడిక్ట్స్ ద టైమ్ ఆఫ్ డెత్. అది విన్న వాళ్ళు చచ్చిపోతారు, వాడు చావడు. అర్సెనిక్ ఆల్బమ్ అనే మందు కూడా ఫియర్ ఆఫ్ డెత్ ఇస్ ద మెయిన్ సింటమ్. కరోనాకి ఎందుకు మనం ఆర్సెనిక్ ఆల్బమ్ ప్రివెంటివ్గా ఇచ్చామంటే, ఎక్కువ మందికి కరోనా పక్కింటి వాళ్ళకి వచ్చిందని కానీ వీడు చచ్చిపోతారు డైలెస్. కరోనాలో డెత్స్ అన్ని భయం వల్ల, మెనీ డెత్స్ ఇన్ కరోనా ఆర్ డ్యూ టు ఫియర్ ఓన్లీ. దట్ ఈస్ వై కరోనా హోమియోపతి, ఇన్ హోమియోపతి కరోనా వీ హ్యావ్ ప్రిస్క్రైబ్డ్ ఆర్సెనిక్ ఆల్బమ్ ఇస్ ద బేసిక్ రెమెడీ, బికాస్ ఆర్సెనిక్ ఆల్బమ్ హ్యాస్ ఎ స్ట్రాంగ్ ఫీచర్ ఆఫ్ ఫియర్ ఆఫ్ డెత్. దట్ ఈస్ ద వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్ విషయం. So, should always know that these symptoms, they speak the person, they speak of the person, they speak of the nature of the disease that has entered. Next. These symptoms, when grouped as one entity, are perfectly curable if a medicine is given which has similar symptoms. So, this was so, similimum, S-I-M-I-L-I-M-U-L, is the fundamental principle of homeopathy. Similimum is the fundamental principle of homeopathy. Next, homeopathy demands a thorough knowledge, T-H-O-R-O-U-G-H, thorough knowledge of the effects of medicines, thorough knowledge of effects of medicines on healthy human beings and their effectiveness on the persons having disorders. are symptoms of the disease. OR are symptoms of the disease. Homeopathy demands a thorough knowledge of the effects of medicines on the healthy human beings and their effectiveness on the disorders or symptoms of the disease. This is what homeopathy experts for us. It is not like allopathy. For headache, you give this. For fever, give this. Like that, it is not there. Biochemic salts they are exception. Though the theory is based on homeopathy, they are exception. We will deal with that also in these 3 weeks. So, what is the basic requirement of a homeopathy doctor is you should have thorough knowledge of the materia medica. Very, very important. And find out the correct medicine. Next. In today, whatever I am giving notes, please go through again. And if any doubt is there, you can Google and know the meanings of it. And 100% you will understand it because I am explaining each other. But you should read it today so that you can understand it. Next. The healing power of the medicine depends on the resemblance, R-E-S-E-M-B-L-A-N-C-E, the resemblance of their symptoms to the symptoms of the patient. The healing power of medicine depends on the resemblance of their symptoms to the symptoms of the patient. This is the success note or key to homeopathic theory. This we have to read again and again and again and again. We need to remember it forever. This is being repeated in the text also many times. That is the only reason. Otherwise, I would not have said so many times. Okay. Next point. Very important point. We should know the homeopathy medicines. We should know the homeopathy medicines as persons, oblique personalities, oblique living personalities, and they should become concrete relatives, concrete, concrete relatives. As you have relatives, somebody XYZ, mama yataya mata elaka sisu mama enak swamika గుర్తుపెట్టుకోగలిగితే ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ డ్రగ్ యూ షుడ్ సీ ఇట్ యాజ్ ఎ పర్సనాలిటీ దట్ టు ఎ లివింగ్ పర్సన్ సే దట్ లివింగ్ పర్సన్ వెనెవర్ యూ సీ ద పర్సన్ సమ్ ఆడ్ బిహేవియర్ విల్ బి దట్ ఎవ్రీబడి విల్ హ్యావ్ సమ్ ఆడ్ బిహేవియర్ దట్ ఈస్ వెరీ కామన్ బికాస్ బై నేచర్ ఎవ్రీ పర్సన్ ఈస్ ఇండివిజువల్ No two persons are alike. I'll give an example. If a person, we ask him to select one color, what is the most liking color, and a number below 100, and along with that, we ask him to select a flower or one vegetable which is liked by him. These four, you just see, it is very, very difficult to find another person having these four likings. Very, very difficult. Something one or two will differ. So the combination of the four in Mr. X will not be found easily in another person's having similar likes. That is why each person is unique, and individualization is again the keynote of medicine. Each person is, whenever somebody comes for treatment to us, we treat him as a unique person. First time we are seeing, first time we are listening to that personality. And in homeo medicines, they are proved on many people, when 20 or 30 people are there. So the drug pictures are very, very different from one person to the person, though there are common symptoms. So the common symptoms are made as materia medica, but there are individuals who are given special symptoms or they react. So each drug you have to study in such a way that the symptoms that are majority of the symptoms that are present in the patient become a part of the medicine. All the symptoms in the medicine will not be present in the patient. Remember, all the symptoms that are present in the medicine, remedy, will not be found in the patient. But majority of the symptoms, maybe all the symptoms in the patient also may not have exact medicine. That is also very difficult. So majority of the symptoms in the patient make a part of the medicine. Patient will have almost all the symptoms that are available. His symptoms will be very good. There are some exceptions will be there. Every rule will have an exception. So, what is a similar remedy? That is the duty of the physician to find out a similar remedy. And if you administer that medicine, I'll tell you, patient is bound to be cured without any exception. Of course, subject to the condition that the patient is not in a very critical condition, where organs are damaged, where surgeries are conducted, where some organs are removed, like tonsillitis, they remove, like appendicitis, they remove the appendix. But there are certain things nowadays, even many things are removed, many, many important organs. God is not a fool to create the organs. No organ should be removed. Remember, everything has a purpose. He has not created without any purpose. Tonsils have a purpose. When the infection enters the person, the tonsils will work as Jaya Vijaya. They are the watchmen, security persons of the Vishnu Vaikuntha. They absorb why the swelling comes in the tonsils, why there is pus formation, why there is infection. The infection is absorbed in the tonsils, they swell and they see that the infection does not go deep into the person or constitution. So it's like removing the security persons, removing the tonsils. Everything has a purpose. Just because the tonsils are getting swollen every now and often, you're getting fever, and the infection is there, fever comes. So they think that this is tonsils is the cause of the disease. Tonsils are not the cause of the disease. Tonsils are our supporters, they help us, they save us. They should never, they are the indicators that some infection has come. That you have to take out with the symptoms again. You have to see the symptoms again. And for those symptoms, if you select a medicine, patient will be cured. This is regular experience of the senior doctors like us. Patient will come and tell, my boy is having tonsils are every now and then. They swell and he is getting a lot of complications like cold, cough, fever, etc. Okay, then we will take down all the symptoms and constitution of the person that by other symptoms you will observe. We give a medicine, tonsils will be numb. This is our experience. Next paragraph. It is the disorder of the activities of internal man. Disorder of the activities of the internal man. Lack of harmony. Balance. Lack of harmony or balance. Which gives out through the form of symptoms, which gives out through the form of symptoms. Full stop. These sensations, oblique symptoms, constitute, C-O-N-S-T-I-T-U-T, constitute the language of disorder, oblique disease. So disease, disorder, oblique disease. So the disease has to express itself. There is some problem that is to be expressed. An infant, suppose he feels hungry, he has to express his hunger by way he cries. Then the mother knows the baby is hungry. So she feeds him. Otherwise, the mother will not be knowing. Suppose the boy is very happy, even without drinking milk or something, is always playing without anything. The mother will not feel what happened. This fellow is okay, no problem. But once he starts crying, then she will come and observe whether it is time for feeding him or is there any pain or something inside the person. He can't express because he does not know to talk. He's an infant, aged months, only a few months baby. But the mother knows. Many people ask us, how do you select a medicine for infants? The mother knows what is the problem. She observes. And we take the symptoms from the mother and select a medicine. 100% patient is found to be there. We have given medicines to days babies also. The day of birth, the boy is not able to pass urine. We give what he is in a shock. We can give aconite, one medicine is there. They can mix it with mother's milk and put a drop on the tongue of the boy or the girl, the infant, the baby. So, homeopathy has such a wonderful medicines denoted by symptoms. And I am giving medicine, veterinary homeopathy also, I am practicing. The owner says symptoms of the animal, and we observe that. We can select a medicine. So, the language of the disease. How do we know the language? How do we know the disease? What is the language of the disease? It is manifested through set of symptoms. So it is next point. So it is the vital force. So it is the vital force that is to be stimulated. That is to be stimulated, S-T-A-M-U-L-A-T-U-D. That is to be stimulated to cure the patient. And only in this way, the patient can be cured. Only in this way, the patient can be cured. We should not resort to suppress the symptoms. There is a pain in the suppress the symptom. I will explain. There is pain in the person. Pain. So pain is an indicator that there is something wrong. Some disease or some disorder has completed the world. Pain is only an indicator. I'll tell you one example. In very big companies, I have seen once in a thermal producing, that is an electricity producing company, Raichur, Karnataka. There is one central control room is there. Very big room, in which all the machines are, that is some dashboard type person is there. There are several bulbs are there. Below that, there's some code number of the mission member or the room member, where problem is that. If suppose a particular place, some motor is giving trouble, a particular bulb will glow, and some siren will come. So the person sitting at that control room will inform the person concerned who was sitting some other place, so on some motor, there is some problem, some deep sound is coming, please go and rectify. So that person engineer will go and rectify. Sitting in one place, this fellow will be monitoring the entire premises of some acres of land. And a few engineers will be there placed in one place and they will go and attend to it. A new person has come, a new person to that control room. He thought that every time one or the other bulb are glowing. So they are not giving me rest. Because only the bulb glows, sound will come. So remove all the bulbs. And everything, there is no sound. Remove the horn, siren charge. So he is sitting. No problem. Somebody came, some supervisor came, is there any problem? No, sir, no bulb is glowing. Everything is okay. But all the machines are stopped. All the motors. Then they have come to know what is the problem. Then this fellow, he told them, they are giving me a lot of trouble, sir. The indicators are removed. Indicators removed does not mean that everything is going on smoothly. No. Indicators are required. Indicators give us the problem, okay, a picture of the problem inside. Symptoms are required. And you have to go symptoms, by symptoms you have to select a medicine. And you should not go one symptom, one medicine. That is also wrong. Because all the symptoms are denoted by, are created from only one source, that is human. Any lakshanalu lopala unnatundi vital force istadu. So that is the reaction of the vital force. All the symptoms direct us to only one place. One person inside. So that person we have to treat. So if a person is dead means the person has left the body, then there is no medicine for a dead person because already healed. This medicine should not be given to that place, organ, or that place where everything is left here. Suppose you give medicine. When the person inside the person left, only body, we call it as body. Then there is no meaning in giving medicine to him. So, but there is something which has left already. That is becoming sick. And that person, he denotes the symptoms. He cries, he says something. As long as he is there inside, treat him. Then automatically all the organs will function in a wonderful way. That is key is, there is a vital force in us. That vital force is to be stimulated. The physician should not directly fight with the disease. So that vital force which is to be stimulated or energy to be added to that. It is already vital energy. It itself has a lot of energy. But the disease energy is more powerful than the vital energy. Then we have to supplement the vital energy or supply the vital energy, more vital energy to it so that it becomes more strengthy, healthy, and that will fight with the disease. The medicine should never fight directly with the disease. So this is the basis. So know the vital force and know the symptoms. And when you select a similar medicine, that is the reason we select a similar medicine which gives stimulation or power to the existing vital power, and that can cure the disease symptoms, and we need not interfere directly with the disease. That is what homeopathy says. I repeat again, we don't hate any system. We love allopathy. We love Ayurveda. Each system has got its own place. Yesterday I gave you the example of a screwdriver and a needle. A needle can sew the cloth, but a screwdriver can unscrew a screws. It cannot work as a needle cannot work as a screwdriver. Screwdriver is not useful when needle is required. Allopathy is useful in its own place. Homeopathy has its own place. Ayurveda also has its own place. Because we are learning homeopathy, we speak more good of homeopathy. We speak more good of homeopathy. Not that we hate other systems. For your information, we like all the systems. Each system is created by God. నెవర్ హేట్. శాస్త్రం ఎప్పుడు తప్పు ఉండదు, శాస్త్రిగా తప్పు ఉండొచ్చు, అది చేసే ఆయన తప్పు ఉండొచ్చు, కానీ ఇంప్లిమెంట్ చేసే ఆయన నాలెడ్జ్ ఆయన తప్పు ఉండొచ్చు, కానీ శాస్త్రం ఎప్పుడు తప్పు. సైన్స్ ఈజ్ నెవర్ రాంగ్. ఎ పర్సన్ హూ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ ఇట్ ఆర్ హూ ఫాలోస్ ఇట్ మేబీ దట్ హీ డస్ నాట్ హ్యావ్ ఫుల్ బాడీ. Hence, don't scold any system. It's not our duty to scold. Let us learn homeopathy. Let us learn good about homeopathy. Let us go deep into the homeopathy. And let us know the advantages of this system more. Not criticizing the other system. This point I tell in all my classes because each one has its own place. Next point. There is a natural law of There is a natural law of cure-like cures. That is similia, similibus curandum. Like cures like. No doubt like that. Like cures like. Next point. That, PHAT, that the single remedy. A single remedy at a time. Very important. At a time. You can give second remedy as a follow-up remedy next time. But a single remedy at a time is all that is needed. Is all that is needed. That is why in homeopathy one medicine is given. That too one medicine in a very small, white, sweet globules, which are very palatable to children. If a doctor, homeopathy doctor, I call him as a divine. Why? Because these infants also like to see the doctor. Homeopathy. Because we don't use injections, we don't kick him or beat him or pierce him with the needle. We give that chocolate, that sweet. So in my experience, even a month's baby loves to see because he says, the medicine is very sweet, so very nice. He asks more medicine. Many people, particularly 4 or 5 years old children, ask them to take only morning one tablet, evening one tablet. They take all the tablets at a time. It so happened in several cases. Actually, homeopathy has no side effects. So even at a time, if you take 10 tablets or one tablet, it amounts to same. Many people have doubt to them. Sir, if you take full bottle at a time, what will happen? Nothing will happen. It is as one day. But you take after 2 minutes, then it is effortless. This is the very advantage of homeopathy. Suppose you take 10 tablets of Dolo 650 at a time, patient will collapse. But in homeopathy, it is not like that. So that a single remedy at a time is all that is needed. No doubt. There is only one person, and if we give one medicine, we can know, if we give one medicine, we can know the action of that remedy clearly. And if it is not similar or does not show its effect, is not similar or does not show its effect, we may have to go for a follow-up remedy. We may have to go for a follow-up remedy. That is very, very important. So when you select a right medicine and right potency, and when it is given to the person, single remedy, we will come to know that medicine has worked or not, how much extent the patient has got relief, whether the second dose or second medicine is required or not, the potency we have to increase. All these things are possible only when you give one medicine. Suppose you give 2 medicines at a time, we will not know which medicine has worked. We will not know whether to repeat or not. All those things we will not be knowing. Hence, that is a problem. That is why we recommend one medicine at a time and one dose. You may have to repeat, depends on the intensity of the disease. There are certain cases where we require to repeat the medicine. it's again, it depends upon the individual's sensitivity. For some person, one dose will work for many hours or days also. For some people, it may work for a few minutes. So we may have to repeat for such persons. So we should know. Next point, please note that a minimum dose is essential. Unfortunately, homeopathy also, there are some people who give many doses or many drugs. In homeopathy, only minimum dose, that is essential, is minimum dose. The minimum dose is essential. Small doses stimulate the vital force. Small doses stimulate the vital force. Next point. The potency is to be selected. The potency is to be selected based on the seat of the symptoms, seat of the symptoms in the patient. Three and six are called low potencies. Three and six are called low potencies. 30 and 200 are called medium potencies. 30 and 200 are called medium potencies. 1 m and above are called high potencies. 1 m and above are called high potencies. So the selection of potency, again, I'm telling you, depends upon the case, each individual case, the sensitivity of the patient, and the vitality of the patient. Suppose the person is too weak, W-E-A-K, weak. Always someone, vitality is too low, then we have to select the potency carefully. And some oversensitive patients will be there. For everything they react in a very high way, oversensitive. For such people also, potency selection is very, very difficult, and you have to do it in a very systematic way. And this comes by experience. Not only the text, it is there, but this is more by experience, by seeing hundreds of people, a selection of potency will come to you. And I told you, in homeopathy, our master E.K. used to say that it is an intuition, more than tuition. Intuition is very, very important. For that, we have to maintain the purity of the heart and the purity of the mind, and that there should not be any manipulation. That is why we run free dispensaries for that purpose, because there we give the medicine with a pure heart. Not that we should not charge. We can charge. If you make this as your own profession, livelihood, there is nothing wrong in taking money for homeopathic medicine. Nothing. You are permitted. But always your aim should be to serve the patient. I am serving a patient. I am serving God, not patient. If any person comes and asks a medicine in your dispensary, feel that Narayana directly, he came. Master Vijayajita Nadachi Vachinavada Narayana. So, in that divine thought, with that divine thought, the divinity, you give the medicine. It will work. Because the medicine itself is divine, not visible by naked eye. Not visible by even powerful eye microscope. Nowadays, we are able to find. Why? Because the God is like that. So it is a divine system. We call it as a divine system. And you should know that the medicine, again, the selection of medicine always depends upon the totality of the symptoms. The totality of the symptoms of the patient have to be tallied with the totality of the symptoms of the medicine. So this is the keynote you should never forget. Even in acute, there is totality. And in this totality also, I am going to tell you in future, the mind symptoms are very, very important. No, one point to note that you can repeat again. In selection of the medicine, please note, in selection of the medicine, the mind symptoms and the causation, and the causation, the cause of the problem, are very, very important. Are very, very important. Next. The individual is important. Individual is important. Full stop. No two people are exactly alike. No two people, TWO, two people are exactly alike. Either in sickness or in health. Either in sickness or in health. I told you an example. I am doing well. Kadhi natchutundi. Untu vaadu logic vaadide vaadu santam. Snanam cheyakunda anandittadu. Endukura nenu snanam chesanu anandichadu. Ekkada undi ravu rule ekkada undi. Pedina suryodayam velaku laavalu chethe ekkada undi nee laapothe em. Inkodu talavartham lechukuntadu 4 lechukuntadu. Adhe vayasunna pilladu. మరి ఎందుకురా పొద్దున్నే లేస్తున్నా చాలా బాగుంటుంది వెరీ బాగుంటుంది వెరీ బాగుంటుంది అవన్నీ కూడా మీకు ఏ ఇద్దరు కూడా ఒకలాగా ఉండరు నో టూ పర్సన్స్ ఆర్ సో దట్ ఈస్ ది ఎఫికసీ ఆఫ్ హోమియోపతి వి ఫైండ్ ఈచ్ ఇండివిజువల్ అండ్ సెలెక్ట్ ద మెడిసిన్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ద టోటాలిటీ ఆఫ్ సింప్టమ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఈచ్ పర్సన్ టేక్ దమ్ టేక్ ఈచ్ పర్సన్ యూ హావ్ టు టేక్ ఇట్ యాజ్ ఎ ఫర్ దట్ పర్సన్ For that set of symptoms, if you select the right medicine and give it in right potency, the patient will be cured. I use Telugu in between only to make one or two persons. They are asking Telugu also. Maybe that they can't understand English. So, but I am translating each word to English also because we have students from various states and countries also. So, I want to see that I reach more people. My communication should reach as many as possible. I think all of you are happy with my explanation, and my rendering is slow, a bit slow, because I want to make you understand the basic principles. Once you understand in the beginning 2-3 classes, then we run fast for medicines, Medical America, and I will tell you. So this is the class today. Any doubts are there, you can ask me. And my request to all of you is, if we can continue with this YouTube, if it is clear, voice is clear, we may discontinue, go to meeting if possible. I don't discontinue immediately, but I request you all to join with YouTube only. So you please find out the number of Shankar. Shankar, you please tell your number so that to join the YouTube, if there any problem, you can contact him. He will give the link. And become a member in the Master Homeo Connect. And if you can subscribe to VVRK Space Shastri, you will receive the link directly that you can join. So subscribe to the YouTube channel VVRK Space Shastri so that you will receive the directly the link. Thank you. And we will close the session here. Any doubts are there, I am open. Either go to meeting, they can ask orally, and the YouTube they can type, and I read and So, thank you. Record stop changing.
Sir, Srinivasulu.
Yeah, Srinivasulu, tell me, sir.
Sir, notes cheppetappudu ee climate ball ante chala sarlu voice to break avutam, sir.
Okay.
Aa sentences complete ga raaskolagutunnamu.
Okay, sir.
Emanna oka notes form lo ichchu sir adi.
Prayatnam cheyadam.
Lekapothe maaku adi sentence avutledu sir adi.
Okay, prayatnam chestam. Repu mundu jagrattapadu. Okay, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any other doubts? Yeah, Kumar. Vijay Kumar. దయచేసి ఆడియో మీరు ఆన్ చేయొద్దు. మీరు ఆన్ చేయగా నాకు పేరు కనిపిస్తుంది. నేను పిలుస్తా. మీరు ఏం లేదంటారు. నా టైం వేస్ట్, మీ టైం వేస్ట్. మీరు మాట్లాడదలుచుకోవడం కూడా మాట్లాడదలుచుకుంటేనే ఆడియో ఆన్, లేకపోతే ఆడియో మ్యూట్ ఉంటుంది. ఓకే నెక్స్ట్.
నమస్తే సార్.
శ్రీనివాసరావు చెప్పండి.
సార్ విత్ వాట్ మెటీరియల్ ద మెడిసిన్ ఆఫ్ హోమియో ఇస్ ప్రిపేరింగ్ సార్?
యా టుమారో టుమారో ఐ యామ్ గోయింగ్ టు టెల్ యు దే ఆర్ ఫ్రమ్ ప్లాంట్ కింగ్డమ్, మినరల్ కింగ్డమ్ అండ్ యానిమల్ కింగ్డమ్. మెడిసిన్స్ ఆర్ ప్రిపేర్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ ప్లాంట్ కింగ్డమ్, మినరల్ కింగ్డమ్ అండ్ యానిమల్ కింగ్డమ్. ఐ గోయింగ్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ యూ సపరేట్లీ, బట్ దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ న్యాచురల్. ఓకే చెప్తాను. అన్ని మనగా ఆయుర్వేదం బేస్తోనే వస్తాయి, ప్లాంట్ కింగ్డమ్ కింగ్డమ్ అండ్ యానిమల్ కింగ్డమ్, ఆల్ ద త్రీ ఆర్. ఓకే చెప్తా. న్యాచురల్ ఎస్ సార్, అన్ని న్యాచురల్, నో సింథటిక్ మెడిసిన్ సార్. Is it somebody
has asked?
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Is it not necessary to condemn the intrusive process of allopathy, which has led to many unnecessary complications? No, sir. We cannot condemn, sir. We should not condemn. It is the rule of the law, rule of the land, and the government only has to encourage homeopathy. Condemning that system where some crores of people are following will lead to some other complications. Let us not condemn somebody. Let us tell good about our system. Why should we condemn? Because when you condemn, they condemn us. Again, a big war will start. Let us not invite negative things. So, we will say that homeopathy is good. You try. But I am telling you everything. The future is of only homeopathy. Future is of only homeopathy. Allopathy is limited to surgical operations. Allopathy will do. But let us not condemn any system because we have to go for only the homeopathy. We will tell good about us. Srinivas, good evening. Your voice is very low in YouTube. That we will see mic something. We will try to use the mic and improve the voice. Is it so with all the persons? Voice is low. Any other person who can respond? Any other person who can respond? The voice is low. Okay. You said that selection of remedy, mind symptoms, causation. Yes, sir. Next, I will explain about that in next classes. Refer books. What I'm asking, don't refer any books right now. At the end of the session, I will recommend certain books. Now, if you open the books, you can't understand, sir. That is the problem. See, this is not right. Network is there. Yeah, headphones, I will try to use headphones. If it improves the voice, I will use it. But is it too bad? Headphones, okay. Many people are telling me. I will try to use that. Headphones,
yeah. Hello?
Yes, sir. Sudha Kannan. Yeah, somebody from GoToMeeting. Somebody is telling we are able to hear clearly. Maybe that their systems also, some cell phones or some laptops are weak. Okay, anyway, we will try to use headphones. Okay. Yeah, somebody is asking master's names, chanting or prayer. Full names also I will tell, sir, separately. Names of the masters. Okay, next. The student should wear headphones. Sir, that is one suggestion. For those people whose voice is low, if you wear headphones for you, it will be clear. That is what one of the students has suggested. You try that. Okay. Okay, sir. And any other doubts? If there are no doubts, we'll close the session. Yeah, Sudha Kannan, you want to tell something? If you are not willing to talk, please keep your phone in mute. Somebody will talk. Yes, sir. to meeting, no voice. Now it has come. No, go to.
Excuse me, sir. Sudha Pandanmiya.
Yeah, tell me, madam.
Sir, you were talking about the potency of medicine, and you told that only correct potency has to be chosen for a patient.
Yes.
Now, if a weak patient is given a high potency medicine, will it create any harmful effects on the patient?
I'll tell you, madam, one or two doses will never give harmful effects on the patient. Unless a very high potency is selected indiscriminately, generally in homeopathy, one or two doses will never harm the patient. And a learned doctor who has come up to the stage of prescription will definitely know the basic rules. Will definitely know the basic rules. Otherwise, he will not venture to prescribe. I ask all the people in my students not to prescribe. First learn. Don't prescribe more. Okay? You work with a senior doctor, you
will. Okay, sir.
Definitely. Next.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. It's better the listener should use headphones, like somebody suggested. Okay. Next. Any other? Yeah. Yogesh.
Hi, sir. Good evening.
Good evening, Yogesh.
Yes, sir. My question is for small infants or kids.
Yeah.
Cannot express their symptoms.
Yeah.
Parents tell their kind of understanding to the doctors.
Okay.
So, is that correct? Or as a physician, person can prescribe right medicine?
There are three things, sir. We will know by observation. Then we take the symptoms from parents. And we also take like a fever, thermometer is there, external problem, chills are there, thirst is there. All those things we can know that. The physiological symptoms and the observation by the parents and our own observations, coupled with these three, if are mixed up, we can definitely find the symptom for either infants or animals also. So we cannot express. It is possible. It comes by experience. The more patients you see, the easily you can say. I told you example, mother will know the feelings of the baby. How will the mother know? What are the symptoms? So like that, you should be a mother to the patient. That motherliness, that affection, if it is there in you, you can find it. Okay? That is the answer.
Sure, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, Rachana.
Sir, are the medicines same for the animals and human beings?
Same. See, any living being, it is called living being, there is life. I told you today that we will stimulate the life force or the vital force. Whether there is life in a plant, there is life in the animal. So we are not giving for medicine for the organs. We are giving only the vital force. So there is life force in animal also.
Yes.
There is life in animal or not?
Yes.
That we are stimulating. So same medicine only.
Okay, sir.
Right.
Thank you.
Somebody asked me how to contact you for consultation. I'm very busy, sir. Number one. Number two, medicine by telemedicine is very difficult. But however, you note down my number 94404 96823. The best time to consult me is morning 9 a.m. evening 9 p.m. These are my consulting hours. Those who are in Bangalore can come to me. Okay, next. I am in Bangalore. You call me by phone, I will do that. If you want to come, I will do that. Otherwise, not. Okay, then we'll close the session here. And generally, 20 minutes I give for question answers. One question I will ask you. Are you able to understand my language and the subject? Somebody please respond.
Sir, one question. Yes, sir.
Yeah, V.S. Rajgar.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I told you V.S. Rajgar.
You said there are symptoms to be matched. What degree if the lower criterion or upper criterion? Because, for example, an ex-womaga can have 1,000 symptoms.
Yeah.
whereas some of the rare drugs, they have lesser number of symptoms.
Yes.
So how are it to match 75%, 80%, 90%? No, because by experience, I understand.
Yeah. Rasgaru, what we do is we go by majority of symptoms. These rare drugs having less. That depends again case to case. The rare drugs which have less number of symptoms, if a patient comes with less number of symptoms and his symptoms mostly suit to that small drug, we can go for rare drugs. But rare drugs.
That doesn't mean you have for the right drug. Whether that is the right drug or not.
No, that is right drug only. When the symptoms tally, that is right drug.
I agree. By extensive reading and
extensive
drug which I am not able to locate is a mind for me.
No, mind problem. It is ultimately what